Bobby, do me an intro.
Hi, we're at Dreamland, Margate, Kent, with Ian. Having a great time.
Hello.
He's on this side of the camera now. For some reason, we found jumbo jet cars for a jumbo jet that was never here.
It's part of Ben Bombs. They're probably doing them up and sending them on to somewhere else. There used to be all sorts of rides here. Looping Star used to be there. There used to be all these airships piled up.
You're surprised to see this here, huh?
Yeah. They used to have this ride that was like a big tower with all airships that went up.
Oh, wow.
Like a space tower, but with airships.
Right here, huh?
They were stuck here for years, just rotting. What's it telling you how to be like that? You go up on car tracks, you go up to the haunted houses.
All that junk, so that's what this is. Oh, good.
Do you want to start it, Robert?
Huh?
Do you want to start it?
Yeah, sure.
You'll have my job by tomorrow, mate.
Okie dokie, then.
Okay, you press that green button in, hold it in, so I'll tell you the left.
You're on camera.
Right, thank you. Right, this is your main...
No pressure.
...main powerhouse for Scenic Railway.
All your drive belts, motors there, chains there,
or cables for your two pull-ups. Give it a quick check, and then we'll see if it's going to run away. There you go. There's tons of them.
I have about 25 rounds of pieces of them.
There's a
Scenic
thing up there, quite a big piece.
Yeah, but I have a Z-Force bolt. I have one Charlie Din gave me, about this big. He said, here, Jack Bolt. I said, sure. And he gave me a tour of the ride. I said, what's your name? He said, Charlie Din. I was like, oh, hi. Nice to meet you.
He was going to give you a t-shirt.
Yeah, he was going to give me a t-shirt, actually.
No.
He was going to give me a t-shirt.
He was going to.
That's a long story, though. I'm going to put that on camera.
Sometimes they jump off and they wear through the axle. So if you do a clutch start, train jumps, the cable jumps,
yikes.
Check them straight away.
That's why you had this here.
Yeah, the cables. Yeah. That weren't there. Kids are playing on it, getting the bottom rail lift up the other side.
Good
and
God.
That starts to wear through the cable and the timbers and stuff like that.
Okay. I guess there was the Scenic Railway Green Armour, that's a cable lift.
Yeah, yes.
I think that's the only one I've ever been on.
Yeah.
walk on the smaller hills or even the grassy areas, that's fine. I said, maybe just a storage shed. I understand if you can't walk on the track. And he wrote back and he said,
there's not much else you can do.
Hold your lines for a minute to retire at 50 cents. Hold your lines for a minute to retire at 50 cents. Thank you.
Hey, hey, hold on. Great, I'm sorry. Margate, Scenic Railway. Bye.
The brakeman has to get in, doesn't he? He has to get in, right?
Yeah, he hops in a minute.
You're riding Ghost.
The thing is, but yeah, it's the same type of track. Not far, right?
Well, Great Yarmouth, they did the same thing. The brakeman got in when the coaster was halfway out, you know. Okay. Cool. Oh, you came down with the camera. Okay. Where's... He can't make it, can he?
There he is.
That went graceful off!
Can't do it gracefully.
Oh! Your turn, it's not as easy as it looks.
Uh-uh.
They should bank it more, shouldn't they?
As far as it's gonna go, but it's down. Oh, what's that?
Guy Geezer. So hi to everyone in the Chatham office. That's an anonymous message there, whatever that means. I don't know. And also hi to John Padgett, Stop Crying, Get On With Your Work, from Grey Duff, Dick Perry at Whelan's in Sheerness. Fair enough. Done what you've asked.
Okay.
Victor FM, Big Brother of
Duty. Oh, I heard the train hasn't come into the station far enough.
Big Brother's had a few stern words with some of the housemates after the party in the reward room the other night, and they played Spin the Bottles.
I learned how to video coasters in Great Drama. I had never videoed before I got there.
On the front seat?
Yeah.
Best not to look through the camera, just hold it.
I learned that on that ride.
Yeah.
Wow, my nose is getting bruised. Oh my god.
There's nothing on, but I thought I broke my nose. I'm sitting here going, oh, my nose!
That's this wheel here.
Oh, okay.
Like that?
Yep.
Push that back.
These are the jaws that take the cable.
Wow.
And snap shuts. So you've got a guide wheel on there for the cable. The cable running on there, along there. That will open, the cable will snap shut from there. It gets to the top of the ramp, that will open again. Drop the cable out to let the train go down.
Wow.
So, when we say, if it stops on a pull-up, we say a gripper rod is gone. These are the gripper rods. They're just normal bolts, normal nuts, but they do wear like everything else. So if one does go, it will shear there or there.
Ooh.
This will drop down, which will stop that jaw from opening or closing. That's when it will miss the cable, and it will stop. You've got two dogs there.
And there are backs, yeah.
There. So it does happen. Those two will dig into the wood at the side of the track, and the main one under the brake, which goes in the teeth that you saw on the pull-up this morning.
It'll roll back, then you have to come up with a crowbar
and a block and shut them manually. You see how highly spring-loaded that is. If you have to open that, when the train's out in the circuit, you have about that much space. Whereas in the shed, you've got all that space to get to it and a hatch like this.
Up there, you've got a couple of inches, you get a crowbar, you lock it behind there, there.
Board there and there to hold the cable up where it should be.
You open that board, it should push the cable in and snap shut.
Right.
If it doesn't,
you do it manually.
This is back here because the gripper rod's gone. Slam that shut.
What kind of tension's on that?
No, well, I mean,
why? It's
lovely, right?
No. they are pretty hard. I mean, it's easier here because there's so much more space to work. But up there, we've only got an inch or two
to work.
You've got to climb under the train and do it. But yeah, it's quite fun to make sure these two are level. They must have opened exactly the same. They're a couple of mil out.
Yeah.
It makes all the difference.
Wow.
That slight bit there, where the cable, possibly cables, great steel cable, could quite easily push that out. So if they're slightly out by a couple of mil, then it'll miss.
Yeah.
The cable will miss the train.
It's tighter here than back there.
Yeah.
It's designed more V-shape.
Yeah, once the cable goes in there, the spring will shut and the cable will pull that tighter anyway. As soon as it releases, because it's going like that.
It's all tension.
If you stay there, I'll move that down. You can have a look at the brake assembly and
that's about it.
Wait a minute, stay clear of what section?
You're okay there at the end of right here. There are bolts and nails sticking to it.
No, he just said stay clear of some section.
I think he said that one.
Is he going to push the train through?
Yeah.
More?
Yeah, he's going to show us the brake. Why don't you get this stuff down so you can see it, but don't get under there.
No, I'm not getting under there.
Okay, so he's moving it now.
This
is a bizarre tour. I've never had anything quite like
this. This is neat.
I wrote my name.
I got...
Huh? Ian was here.
Come here your whole life.
I've got your head in one corner and his head in another corner and the whole train up underneath.